So clinical registries have been an incredibly powerful tool for characterizing disease in specific populations, for identifying event rates and looking at treatment patterns. The there are a couple of challenges associated with using or putting together a clinical registry. It's very resource intensive. You have the very clean data collection, but it's a lot of work to get that data and get it how you want it. Clinical registries also tend to be very targeted on a particular patient population or disease, and you have a very targeted data collection. So we've learned a lot from clinical registries and we'll continue to do so. The electronic health record data represents kind of the next step or another way of approaching problems. You have a more general population because you don't have that consent, that, you know, that stopping and asking for consent that maybe selects out different kinds of patients. You have all the data that's available that's taken, you know, that's collected in the course of clinical care. And that's, you know, there are huge pros to that. You get all that data, but then you also may not have some of the patient-reported outcomes, for example, that you would like to see and that you would make a point of collecting in the clinical registry. So some limitations in using electronic health record data is that you've really got to think about who it is you're seeing in your database. There's a reason why people touch the health system, and it may or may not be related to your outcome of interest. You may be getting a sicker population because those are the people who are coming in who need care. You could be getting people who have better access to care and are therefore healthier. So there are a lot of things to think about. There's methods development. We have a lot of faculty, biostatistics and bioinformatics faculty, for example, who are spending time really characterizing the kind of biases we see in electronic health record data. We're applying a lot of the traditional statistical methods used to handle missing data and used in observational research. They apply here. It's just a question of figuring out what those biases are and where the methods apply. So another great example is this project we just did with IBM and the Exploris database. They were very interested in our characterization of their population in terms of its usefulness for research. And we, I think, have given them some great feedback, and they have been very responsive to that feedback. And we also are helping them identify what are appropriate uses for their database. Well, I think it extends our reach. Like when we partner with the people who are putting out these databases, then we have a seat at the table. We're really working with them and getting the message out there that DCRI cares about quality. And we bring that commitment to quality to a commercial enterprise that is making their data available anyway, but we're just kind of helping them bring it up another notch.